Tulsidas ji describes this very beautifully in the Ramayana when he says, Sadhak Siddha Vimukta Udasi Kavi Kovida Kritagya Sanyasi Yogi Sura Sutapas Jnani Dharma Nirat Pandit Vigyani Tarahina Binuseye Mam Swami Rama Namami Namami Namami. He says no matter who someone is, and he named many people, Sadha, Siddha, Vimukta, Udasi, Jnani, Yogi, Dharmi, Karmi, Pandita, Vidyani, all these people, no matter who they are, none of them can reach God without surrendering. So surrender means bhakti. Bari mathe baru hoye grita, sikata te baru tel, binu hari bhajana na bhavatariya, yah siddhanta apela. He makes a challenge, Tulsidas ji does, that let's say someone could make other impossible things possible, like churning water and getting ghee by churning water, or getting oil out of dry sand. Is it possible? No, it's impossible. But let's say someone could make it possible, even then they could not cross this ocean of Maya without surrendering to God. They cannot become God realized. That's what it all comes down to. Krishna says in the Gita, Daivi hyesha gunamayi mama maya duratyaya mameva ye prapadyante maya metam tarantite. Hey Arjun, this maya is an endless ocean. It's uncrossable. Maya, God's power. He says, Mama Maya. That Maya is the cosmic power that when Krishna activates it, Maya manifests the universe or unfolds into the form of the universe. That Maya is a cosmic ocean. It's endless. And a soul needs to cross Maya in order to reach God. Tameva viditvati mrityu meti nanya pantha vidyate yanaya. Shweta Shvatra Upanishad says that in order to reach God, you have to cross something. What is that thing you need to cross? Maya. And how to cross Maya? Not through one's own effort, only through self-surrender. And that self-surrender is another word for bhakti. Just like God has many names, we can call him Anand, we can call him happiness, we can call him peace, we can call him Krishna, Ram. All these names mean the same thing, are the same thing. So you can say also bhakti, you can say surrender, you can say devotion, they all mean the same thing. So only through bhakti can we attain our ultimate goal of God realization. That much Krishna has made clear in the Bhagavatam. Uddhao asked him, out of all of the paths, which one is the right one? So the question is, what do you want? If you want perfect happiness, you must attain God, then there's only one path, the path of bhakti. That leaves the other half of Uddhao's question. Why are there so many other paths? If there's only one goal for any soul, which is to attain God, then why all the other paths? There's a simple answer to this also. Jap tap niyam yoga nij dharma shruti sambhav nana shubha karma jnan dayadam tirath majjana Jalagi dharma kahe shruti sajjana agam nigam purana aneka सब साधन कर यह फल सुंदर. Ramayana says all those other paths are to induce a person towards the path of bhakti. They are all meant to develop love in the heart or to develop a desire in someone's heart to attain God. Sab karmat khagnayak eha kariyaram pad pankaj neha jahan lagi sadhan ved bakhani sab kar phal hari bhagati bhavani. All of the practices, all of the different sadhanas told in the Vedas, they're all for only one thing, to bring a person towards the path of bhakti. But, Krishna says, people have confused the matter over time. Yatha prakriti sarvesham chitra vacha sravantihi bhagavatam. Is explaining further to Uddhao that in the Vedas I told only one thing, how a soul can come to me. But there are four kinds of people in the world, tamas, rajas, sattvic, and divine. Divine means a God-realized saint who has crossed Maya with God's grace and now has a divine mind. So let's leave the saints aside for now. In this world, among us ordinary people, there are three types of people. Those with tamas pravritti, those with rajas pravritti, and those with sattvic pravritti. In our mind, we have all three gunas, but one is going to be more prominent than the other two. So someone with tamas pravritti, when he reads Vedas, he's going to interpret the meaning of the verses in a tamas way. If a rajas person interprets the same verse, he'll interpret it in a rajas way. And if a sattvic person interprets it, he'll interpret it in a sattvic way, and all three are wrong. Only the saint with a divine mind can give the correct interpretation, because Vedas are themselves divine. Therefore, all the other paths that are described as subsidiary paths to bhakti. Someone may have said, this subsidiary path, no, this is the main thing, because this appeals to my intellect. I like this path, so this is the main thing. And they might take two or three verses from a scripture and take it out of context and say, this is the main thing, this is what you have to do. And someone else is saying, no, this is the main thing. Dharma meke ashashchanye kamam satyam damam shamam anye vadanti swartham va aishwaryam tyaga bhojanam kechid yagya tapodanam vratani niyamanyaman adyantavanta evaisham loka karma vinirmita. Dukho darkastamo nishtha chudrananda shucharpita. Bhagavatam. Krishna is telling Uddhav very clearly, he named all the other paths. Dharma meke yashaschanye. He says, everybody finds their thing that appeals to their mind, because all of that is in the Vedas. The Vedas are like an unlimited bazaar, a big market with something for everybody. So someone says, doing good actions is the main thing. You have to do good actions. Someone else says, no, try to become famous, because after you die, what will stay behind? Your name. Someone else says, just live for today. Fulfill all your worldly desires, because who knows what will happen after today. Someone else says, telling the truth, through telling the truth in every situation, that's the best thing you can do. And on and on and on.